A very good morning to all. Looking at important headlines from the Hindu newspaper for 6th May, on the front page you have Orisha struggles to put life back on track. So this is regarding cyclone, the extremely severe cyclonic storm Fani, which hit coastal Orisha. So the administration is now struggling to cope with the Herculean task of restoring power, water supplies in the worst affected cities of Bhubaneswar and Puri. Then this is fifth phase of the Lok Sabha elections. 51 seats to go to polls in the fifth phase. So these are the regions shown here, you can see. Then below you have Hermit breaks 194-day fast for Ganga after government promise. So this is 27-year-old hermit in Haridwar. This is Swami Atma Bhudanand. So he has broken his 194-day fast in protest against sand mining and upcoming dams on key rivers that feed Ganga. So after government promise, he has broken his fast. Also, you should know that there is another person from a professor and hermit, G.D. Agarwal, who was 86-year-old. He was fasting on the issue and he died of heart attack on October 11 after 111-day fast. So after that, hermit Atma Bodhanand, he began fasting. Then on page 2 you have Cyclone Fani damages houses in Meghalaya. So you should know that after striking Odisha, so the cyclone has moved further up and is affecting the northeastern region too, West Bengal, northeastern region. So this is in Meghalaya where houses have been damaged and one was injured. On page 7 you have below regarding in Assam allegations of false NRC objections. So minorities body says that all Bodo Students Union took signatures on blank forms. So such allegations have been made. And this is India-UK in talks to build a naval supercarrier. So this is a report in which it is said that the two countries together will build state-of-the-art aircraft carrier along the lines of Britain's HMS Queen Elizabeth as part of Make in India negotiations. On the editorial page, the first editorial is Surviving Fani. So this is regarding the extremely severe cyclonic storm Fani which hit Orisha. The Orisha government has shown an example of how to manage a natural disaster because casualties have been minimized. Even UN has praised the administration and the government. Then this is Endless Crisis. So this is regarding Venezuela in South America. So the Maduro Guaido standoff is deepening Venezuela's economic distress too. So that is highlighted in this editorial. The lead article as such here is the difference between a job and work. So it says work satisfies a deeper urge than livelihood, while if denied takes significant political and social toll. So work is something which will be satisfactory. And it says that is what is required, generating work. Then below is talking fair trade in Delhi. So this is regarding WTO mini ministerial meeting which took place where developing countries, it says, must make a case for stable and transparent multilateral trade. So this is a trade talk which is going to take place in Delhi for developing countries, a mini ministerial meeting, WTO mini ministerial meeting. So we need a stable and transparent multilateral trade order. That's what is required for developing countries. Then on the op-ed page you have what we need today, social justice. So it says the victims of capitalism have always been the disadvantaged sections of society. So what we need is social justice for them because the rich become richer and the poor poorer. Then this is on international page you have toll in Gaza fighting rises to 8. So when Gaza's region of the Palestinian region, when it saw rockets being targeted at Israel, Israel came with full force on it and this massive strikes which have been ordered by Israel have resulted in huge destruction and loss of lives in Gaza. And this is Kim oversaw testing of tactical weapons. So North Korea has again started testing weapons and it's on Saturday it conducted strike drills in violation of UN resolutions too. and this is US to hike tariffs on 200 billion of Chinese goods. So trade talks are moving too slowly is what US President Donald Trump says, and now again it is hiking tariffs on Chinese goods. Then on Mondays you have this business review coverage. So the first article is regarding National Stock Exchange, the punishment which has been given by SEBI to National Stock Exchange. We have already covered it on the co-location issue. This is regarding airlines, how airlines have been faring. And below is an important article, no guarantee that bank privatization will be a panacea. So this is Raghuram Rajan, former RBI governor. He says that we need to recognize that ownership is just one contributor to governance and look at pragmatic ways to improve governance across the board. So this is very important. Then on the last page you have training for marathon reverses aging of vessels, cuts stroke risk. So this is a study that says that novice runners had 4-year reduction in arterial age after training. So these are the important headlines. For detailed coverage of current affairs, you can visit our website asha.com. Also, with the keywords initiative in current affairs, we are going to upload more on science and technology. So science and tech mobile has already been uploaded, so you can download the current affairs PDFs. So it is in the topic wise current affairs on the website asha.com, the current affairs section. So here you can see, so here topic wise keywords for prelims 2019. So already we have uploaded for SNP Nobel. Culture was already earlier uploaded. You can download the PDF here. So this is the topic wise coverage. This is Nobel. Today even SNT space would be uploaded. So you can wait for that. The PDF would be downloadable. So that is it. Thank you.